For the last week, for the seventh month in a row, we have gone for between 3 days to a full week with no water coming through the mains. When we have investigated this, it proves to be a problem between two government parastatals. Basically, our local water company, Mawasco, pays bills to Coastal Water, who is then supposed to pay the Kenya Power and Light Company. Kenya Power and Light, for the last 2 or 3 years, has cut off Coastal Water Board and Mawasco for lack of bill payment. But it isn't the current bill that isn't being paid. It's a bill from many years ago. So it's an arrears bill that isn't being paid. So despite all of the stakeholders in this area, from the hotels to the hardware stores to the vegetable growers paying their monthly bill, and then the current bill being paid to KPNL, KPNL continue every single month to cut off the water company because of arrears. We are pleading, begging, stating that this has to stop.
The tourism is the 90% of income and give 90% of the work for the people here. So this problem we are accept of closing down the business because we cannot survive in this way. We cannot spend the money that we are spending now to buy the water from outside, from with the lorry. Then also, it's not only a matter of money. It's also the problem is to find the water because there are very few lorry and the price go up every day like crazy.
I want to tell who is the responsible for this. If in case of any case of any fire, how we are going to be sorted out? This town, there is all the hotels, even the houses are surrounded by Makuti. In case of any cause happened, the fire, how we are going to sort out this issue? This is the major issue. We have to think about tourism and locals both together. As we are working with all the staff are local, we were asking them, every day they are coming late because of the same issue of the water. There we have a problem of the hygiene. If there is no water, also this is the problem of the hygienic. The diseases will increase. Who will be the responsible for that?
This is a place which is surviving with tourism, and we have to give a good service to all. We have experienced a very nice season with a lot of people coming also from Nairobi and start to prefer Watamu and Malindi to other places, even abroad. So we are lucky and we are happy to give a good service, which it means not only hotel hospitality, but good food and good safaris everywhere, and showing how Malindi and Watamu are growing as a tourism attraction destination. So why a problem between two parastatal companies can affect so much us? In this statement, we will write all unite, more than 100 of stakeholders. We are asking the government, please, to solve politically the matter and to come to a zero and to start again for the supplying of water.